Restoration is an art unto itself. We imagine highly trained individuals crammed in the basement of a museum, slaving over the art with many tiny paintbrushes.
If everything you're doing is bad, I want you to know this.
But occasionally, things go wrong, resulting in hilarious consequences. For this list, All Things Top 5 ranks the top 5 funniest art restorations from around the world. Sometimes there are only mistakes and not just happy little accidents.
And just beat the devil out of it.
Number 5, Potato Head of Palencia. Behold the latest art restoration gone completely wrong in Spain. Located on a historic facade in the Spanish city of Palencia, this sculpture was once a stunning masterpiece dating back to 1922, that is until its head fell off. This statue has been left disfigured after a mysterious restorer tried to repair his dismembered head, resulting in a melted face with two round cavities standing in for eyes, a misshapen lump for a nose, and a mouth reminiscent of a blow-up doll.
Dear God, how about a heads up or an NSFW warning? Is that a blow-up sex doll?
Ooh, I want to see.
When the head was reunited with his body, the locals noticed something was not quite right. Its once beautiful face now looked like a skinned potato. It remains unclear who created this abomination, but artists and restorers have made it clear that it was not a professional.
The eyes, they burn!
Number 4, Ain't George. When the Church of San Miguel de Estella in Navarre, Spain, set out to restore its 500-year-old statue of legendary Saint George on horseback, clad in armor, and fighting a dragon, it wasn't counting on becoming the laughingstock of the internet. The sculpture was commissioned to be restored by the parish priest of the church and was carried out by a local arts and craft teacher known simply as Carmen by the media. Unfortunately, the 500-year-old sculpture now resembles something out of a children's cartoon. The paint has left St. George with a rosy pink face, a comically red and gray suit of armor, and beady little eyes.
With your beady little eyes and flapping heads, you're trash!
I resent that! I find that racist!
The church and the company responsible were both fined 6,000 euros. Fortunately, after 3 months of work, at a cost to the church of 33,000 euros, the artwork has been successfully unrestored to its original appearance. This is around 3 times what it would have cost to have it professionally restored in the first place.
It's beautiful!
Number 3, Santa Barbie. Historian Milton Teixeira was shocked to discover that an overenthusiastic restorer hoarded up the statue of Santa Barbara at Brazil's Santa Cruz de Barra Chapel.
Bit of an overreaction, don't you think? You look like a whore.
The dramatic makeover gave the statue a pale complexion, over-the-top eyeliner, gaudy wardrobe, and a deer in a headlight expression. The process to undo the damage took 6 months and remove up to 4 layers of paint to restore the statue's original appearance. Teixeira, a frequent visitor to the church for 20 years, was nonetheless horrified. In what turned into an episode of Extreme Makeover, Teixeira told the local news outlet that they turned Santa Barbara into Barbie.
I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world, wrapped in plastic. It's fantastic. Come on, Barbie, let's go party. Yeah.
Number 2, Sweet Baby Jesus. A Canadian church had a vandalism problem, where local thugs repeatedly decapitated the head of baby Jesus held by the Virgin Mary.
We were just saying we'd love to meet the guy who cut off the head of that statue.
Yeah, we wish you were here right now.
Yeah, we'd break every bone in his stupid little body.
So local artist, Heather Wise, stepped in and offered to create a replacement head free of charge, and the church happily accepted. But what they got was a spiky-headed monstrosity that looked less like baby Jesus and more like a meth-addicted Maggie Simpson.
Jeez, come on. Don't make me put you under warm water. I give up.
Heather Wise claimed that the terracotta face, which soon began melting in the rain, was just a temporary placeholder while she carved a stone replacement. After seeing all the media coverage, the remorseful thief felt guilty and returned the original head. Heather Wise, however, wanted her spiny turtle shell from Mario Kart back because it turned out to be her most famous work of art. Before we get to number one, remember to subscribe to All Things Top 5 and ring the bell to be notified for our latest videos. Number one, Monkey Jesus. A sweet old lady named Cecilia Jimenez attempted to restore Ecce Homo, a century-old fresco of Jesus crowned with thorns, and put her small Spanish town of Borja, Spain on the map. The octogenarian had the best of intentions when she set out on her own, and without permission, to work on the deteriorating fresco, but her skills were not quite up to the task.
It's a real piece of s***. Oh, well, tell me what you really think.
The restoration is universally mocked as Monkey Jesus, or Ecce Mono, which is Latin for Behold the Monkey.
Monkey Jesus could have ripped off the Romans' arms and masturbated all over their bodies, but he chose love instead. And I think that makes him pretty darn special.
Ironically, the botched restoration draws 4 times more tourists every year, and the sweet old lady is now considered a local hero. However ugly the fresco may be, Monkey Jesus is printed on t-shirts, appeared in a small film, and nearby vineyards are fighting over the right to use the image on wine labels. In an ironic twist, that not-so-sweet lady Cecilia has hired 2 lawyers who now insist that she deserves a cut of the church's profits, proving that art is truly in the eye of the beholder.
Oh, Jesus! Oh, God! Oh, oh, Jesus! God! Oh, Mary, Mother of Jesus! Jesus of Nazareth!
Do you agree or disagree with our list? Did these amateur artists end up creating something more popular than the original? Comment below and watch our other videos, and subscribe to All Things Top 5.